Hail Holy Mother, who gave birth to the King, who rules heaven and earth forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Hail Holy Mother, who gave birth to the King, who rules heaven and earth forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I welcome you to Mass on the Saturday memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And we're offering our Mass especially today for the good state of Michael Sermon. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are almighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Word made flesh, the Spirit of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O God, that we, your servants, may rejoice in unfailing health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of the Blessed Mary and the Virgin, may we be set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you really my son Esau? And he replied, who smelled the smell of his clothes. He blessed him, saying, "Yes, the smell of my son is like the smell of a fertile field blessed by the Lord. May God give you dew from heaven and the richness of the earth, abundance of grain and wine. May nations serve you and peoples bow down before you. Be master of your brothers. May the sons of your mother bow down before you. Cursed be he who curses you. Blessed be he who blesses you." Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good.
Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good.
Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the servants of the Lord, who stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God.
Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good.
Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good. Sing a psalm to his name, for he is loving. For the Lord has chosen Jacob for himself, and Israel for his own possession.
Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good.
For I know the Lord is great, that our Lord is high above all gods. The Lord does whatever he wills, in heaven, on earth, in the seas.
Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good.
Alleluia. Nor do people put new wine into old wineskins. If they do, the skins burst, the wine runs out, and the skins are lost. No, they put new wine into fresh skins, and both are preserved. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
July is dedicated to the precious blood of Christ. And the Church continues to use the bread and wine, just as Christ did at the Last Supper. They appear ordinary, but as the first fruits of the earth, we are strengthened and cheered by their use. Bread is our staple. We petition our Father for our daily bread, the nourishment needed for our life. The fruit of the vine quenches our thirst, but is also an expression of our joy, making these gifts very suitable for our thanksgiving. From their outward appearance, they tend to be easily recognisable as the body and blood of Christ. But if they are merely symbolic, then to hell with them, as they would only be idols. They would be unworthy of our adoration. Sadly, many people have not deepened their Eucharistic theology past the symbolic representation. The preparation of gifts also demonstrates the true destiny of our human nature. In ancient times, wine was too coarse and needed to be cut with water to make it drinkable. From a practical point of view, the Church did the same, but saw added significance in adding a small amount of water into the wine. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share
in the divinity of Christ, who humbles himself to share in our humanity. A small amount of water, humanity, is absorbed by the wine, divinity. But if out of pride we add too much water, the wine will break down, becoming unsuitable for the offering. This should remind us that the principal actor in the Mass is Christ himself, and we, with him, are permitted to participate in it. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Now that the gifts are prepared, the Church gathers at the foot of the cross. But what about the lamb that was at Passover? Christ, the unblemished lamb's hour has come. He is to be offered to the Father, the lamb who takes away the sins of the world. Our own offering is a humble prayer and petition to God, offered for the Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to God, uniting government throughout the whole world, in union with those who hand over the Catholic faith. The Mass is offered for the people, their good estate, or the repose of their soul, but for ourselves too, in hope of health and well-being, wishing to be delivered from eternal damnation, counting on the flock of those God has chosen through Christ our Lord. In the words of consecration, the priest becomes Christ. His own personality has been absorbed in persona Christi, so that Jesus, the author of life and the author of our salvation, is here declaring, "This is my body, this is the chalice of my blood," leaving no doubt as to the reality of his presence on the altar. The sacred species are shown to us for adoration. In the words of St. Thomas, "My Lord and my God." In ancient Israel, without the shedding of blood, there is no effective way of dealing with offences. And so the blessing cup that we bless is a communion with the blood of Christ, attaching us to that new and eternal covenant, yes, washing away our sins, but also uniting ourselves to the life of Christ, and especially his sacrificial death for our good and the good of all his holy Church. The priest's communion is an indispensable and essential part of the Mass. Without it, the sacrifice is incomplete and the intention is left hanging. The people's communion is optional but recommended, providing, of course, we are properly prepared and disposed. Already fed by God's word, they are nourished now by the bread of life from the hands of the priest who has confected the Eucharist, or perhaps from the deacon who shares in the apostolic task of helping at the Lord's table. Communion under both kinds may be a fuller sign of the Eucharistic meal, a banquet, but it is not a fuller reality of the Eucharist, for we receive the fullness of Christ himself entirely, body, blood, soul, and divinity, under either species. For to eat Christ's body is also to receive his blood. After making a personal thanksgiving, for of course the whole Mass is itself Eucharistic, a thanksgiving, the liturgy concludes promptly with the dismissal, or more accurately, a commission. They say, "Missa est, go, you are sent, sent to announce the gospel of the Lord, so that many more people may come and share in these signs of the Lord's goodness."
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through to the earth and what we have human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice to your hands. Praise the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven, and the blessed seraphim, worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord.
Especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysognus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept the salvation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect.
Make it spiritual and acceptable, so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying,
"Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up
for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as ones you are pleased to accept the gift of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have come before us with a sign of faith, and rest in a state of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, in all seeking Christ, the place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who know the sinners, hope in your abundant blessings, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen the Fire, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not wearing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, for whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify and fill me with life, bless them and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And the Savior, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Blessed is the womb of the Virgin Mary, which bore the Son of the Eternal Father. Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech you, Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, so I'm a little bit.